All right, so today we are looking at the Argon ONE V5 for the Raspberry Pi 5 and some additional accessories from Argon 40. It has been my long-standing opinion that Argon 40 makes the best enclosures for Raspberry Pi boards, and Argon 40 has once again delivered with a premium case and accessories to support expandability for your Raspberry Pi 5. Along with the Argon ONE V5, we have the Industria OLED module and the Dataterm 128GB NVMe SSD. In this video, I'm going to assemble this case with my 8GB Raspberry Pi 5. And while you watch, I want you to think critically about how you can use this setup for your next Raspberry Pi project. The Argon ONE V5 uses the same design language as previous Argon ONE cases. Casted aluminum for passive cooling and a fan for active cooling. And of course, the included PCB for full-size HDMI. The Argon ONE V5 goes a bit further with two additional front-facing USB 2.0 ports, a built-in DAC with 3.5mm mic and headphone jacks, and an internal USB port for a Zigbee module. Finally, you have the option to add a single or dual slot NVMe SSD board. Assembling the Argon ONE V5 is straightforward. Inside the box, you have screws, thermal pads, and other accessories, including the HDMI breakout board. The V5 is composed of three major sections: the lid, middle section, and the bottom plastic cover. So the first thing you want to do is connect the breakout board to your Raspberry Pi. Next, you want to put on your thermal pads. Now from here, we're going to attach the Raspberry Pi with the breakout board to the middle section of the V5 case. You want to take four of the screws and secure the Pi and the breakout board to the middle case. I did this off camera, but you want to also plug in the Pi's fan cable and the power supply cable for the NVMe drive. I'm going to prep the Dataterm NVMe for installation, but before I do that, I want to point something out to you. All Argon 40 cases that support NVMe drives have removable standoffs for various NVMe drive sizes. And with the Argon ONE V5, you're pretty much covered with whatever drive size you have. So now we have to connect the PCIe cable to the board and the Raspberry Pi. The easiest way to do this is to unlatch each connector and then slot in the cable. Now, before we install the bottom portion, I'm going to install the thermal pad for the NVMe drive. There is a bit of plastic on either side, so just remember to remove that before you install the bottom case. Now from here, we can install the bottom portion of the case, and you'll have to use four screws to attach it to the middle section. So at this point, we can prep the OLED module. The first thing we need to do is remove the plastic cover from the top of the case, and they are held together with two Phillips head screws. Installing the OLED module is straightforward. You remove the plastic protection cover, and then you attach it to the top case using the two Phillips head screws. And from there, you can plug in the OLED module cable into the GPIO pins on the Raspberry Pi 5. Now with the OLED module installed, we want to secure the top case to the middle case with the remaining Phillips head screws. Finally, we can install the rubber feet and the micro SD card cover. And with that, the case is complete. The Dataterm NVMe drive comes pre-installed with Raspberry Pi OS. So I'm going to set this up, and then I'll show you how to install the script for the V5 case. Now after you set up and update your Raspberry Pi, you want to open up Terminal and you want to type in the following command. The The script is installed, so now I'm going to reboot. All right, so the system has rebooted, and now I'm just going to click on the Argon configuration tool. Now, there are several options you can choose from in the configuration tool, but for this video, we're going to choose one for configuring the OLED module. Now, in this menu, you have four options, and I want to configure the pages or what displays on the OLED, so I'm going to choose option two. From here, you can add or remove pages that display on the OLED screen. For this video, I'm just going to demonstrate how to remove the IP address from the display rotation. So I'm going to press 7, and now it will no longer display on the OLED module. So this summarizes the basic functionality of the Argon ONE V5 case. As a standalone enclosure, the Argon ONE V5 works great for Raspberry Pi OS, an entertainment box, or an emulation device. There are some additional accessories for the Argon ONE V5 that I don't have just yet. And if you want to see my future plan for this case, make sure you subscribe so you don't miss the next video. If you want to pick up the Argon ONE V5 or any of the accessories, links in the description. I'm Jason, and I will see you in the next one.